How old are you?
17.
How long have you been 17?
A while.
This is wrong, Edward. She's not one of us.
I'm not scared of you.
You really shouldn't have said that.
Stephanie Meyer's Twilight series has been getting a lot of press lately, especially since the fourth book in the series titled Breaking Dawn was released on August 2nd to huge sales. And this month, the movie version of the book will be hitting theaters nationwide. The message you might have heard is that these teen romances take a strong stand against sex before marriage and are therefore a great way to get that idea to us. Ordinarily, I'd be stoked about a mainstream, well-written series of books for girls with a pro stay away from losers message, but in this case, I still have my reservations. The basic storyline is this. A teenage girl named Bella falls in love with a mysterious, much older vampire named Edward. She wants to become a vampire like him so they can be together forever. But what they're failing to notice is this. Bella is completely without self-confidence. She's constantly putting herself down and treating her boyfriend as some superior being. She looks down on herself just for being a human and wants to lose her humanity as soon as possible. Now, God willing, when the day comes and my wife finishes medical school and I become a little more mature and we are lucky enough to have a little girl of our own, I want her to be defined not only as someone who can hold off from sex, I want her to be defined by a strong sense of who she is. I hope she takes for her role models, not women who are naive, gullible, and lacking in self-worth, but rather women who are intelligent, strong, and who can stand up for themselves and for what is right. I want her to understand that she's created in God's image and has infinite value and worth. Understand that I, Justin, don't burn books and advocate reading only Christian subculture books. I hope my steady diet of one book a week goes to show that I truly believe in the age-old adage that readers are leaders. And I hope you understand that I do advocate critical thinking in both the fields of content and style when it comes to books. Which I remind you again, I find Christian novels lack in both.